Sound is typically generated by the movement of the membrane, like in loudspeakers, vibration of strings, or with some resonating structure, as in many musical instruments. Surprisingly, there are other ways to generate sound, and particularly this actuator doesn't involve any moving parts, but it can still produce sound with the help of atmospheric corona discharge. Let us listen how it sounds. Maybe I'm foolish, maybe I'm blind, thinking I can see through this and see what's behind. Got no way to prove it, so maybe I'm lying. But I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all. Don't put your blame on me. Don't put your blame on me. Construction of this prototype is very simple. It consists of two metallic electrodes, a perforated plate like this, and a long thin wire. We used a nichrome wire with the diameter of 0.1 mm. And here is the dielectric frame separating the electrodes. The plate is screwed on one side of the frame, and on the other side we string the wire so that its parts are parallel to each other and spaced equally with the plate. Here is how the assembled prototype looks. When the plate is grounded and, for example, positive high voltage applied to the wire, in our case it's around 7 kV, the ionization of air starts in the narrow region around this thin wire. It happens because locally the electrical field magnitude exceeds the value of electrical breakdown in the air, and so we have the corona discharge. Then these ions drift in the mean electric field to the perforated plate. While moving, they collide with neutral air particles in this gap between the electrodes. Important thing is that the energy of these ions is not enough to provide further ionization, so they just transfer momentum to neutral air in elastic collisions. So basically, the ions from coronal discharge accelerate a volume of air between the electrodes from wires to the perforated plate. And the plate collects all the ions, but the air moves further through. It means that this actuator in constant voltage regime works actually like a fan, and you can really feel it putting the hand behind the grid. The air velocity produced is proportional to the voltage we apply. High voltage will accelerate the airflow further, lower voltage will slow it down a bit. And what is more interesting, we can add an AC voltage component to the constant one, and if the amplitude is high enough, we will accelerate and decelerate the flow, creating the compression of air, and in the end, we will produce sound. Of course, as in many atmospheric gas discharges, this actuator produces some amount of ozone, which can be harmful to breath a lot. But this actuator can find some nice applications in industry, because it can be quite transparent. We can use some more transparent green than this one. It is rather compact in this dimension. The thickness is less than 1 centimeter. And it doesn't have any moving parts. No moving parts means no resonance in the frequency response, which is also good for some sound reproduction. And the final thing, that the actuator itself, without any connecting infrastructure, is pretty light. So I hope this video was interesting for you. Thank you for watching.